Welcome to the week four go-to session, which is the final session of the month. Yay! I hope everybody can see my screen. Someone let me know in the chat. If you do not, you should be seeing kind of the week four screen, right? That shows all the activities in this class. So last week, no one showed up for the lecture. I think I got a last minute message from, can't remember, it's Kobabis or Tysa. Someone showed up in the lecture, I think, kind of late, maybe 15 minutes after it started. And that's right when I ditched. Right? Like students have that 5 minute rule or 10 minute rule. In the physical classroom, if the teacher doesn't show up, everybody takes off. Well, that was kind of me. I hung out for 15 minutes, saw that no one was here. And then I did upload a recording from last month. So I covered the exact same information every month. So there was no real loss, except for I came to campus for no reason. I'm here on campus again. I don't know. I chalk it up to last week. Last week was the first week where the coronavirus stuff kind of got real. A lot of people had to stay home. We were ordered to stay home. Oh, gosh. This Friday, it will be 2 weeks. So anyway, I come into campus two or three times per week anyway, just because I work better from here. Kobabis says, keep saying loading. What keeps saying loading? As long as you can hear me or see my screen, or are you saying you can't see my screen? Because I think I have my screen selected. Let's see. Yeah, it should be focused on the class itself. Like you should be seeing, like here I'm circling my cursor around week three. All last week, the lecture, it kept saying loading. That probably happened maybe, do you mean you showed up on time at exactly 7 p.m. and it kept saying loading? That might have been an issue on your end, I'm not sure. Or it might have been if you showed up late that like there was no session. I don't know, but for whatever reason, I was here. I was ready to have it, even if there was just one person. But anyway, this is the final lecture of the month. And this will be shorter because I don't have that much to go over. Okay, so here we are, just finished week three. I graded all the Map It Out submissions, and I'm working on the essay that was due on Sunday. Okay, so that's where I am at right there. Feel free to take the grammar quiz. I know for one of the sections, I accidentally had it disabled, so you might not have been able to get in. But the grammar quiz is real simple. You just take it a few times, and it automatically gives you 100. At the end of the month, I usually enter 100, so people didn't take it anyway, so, but take it, it's for fun. But here we are in week four, okay? So week four, there's no grammar quiz. We got two major activities, so that's what I'm going to cover tonight. This guy right here, the 4.3 called Gather the Right Pieces, and 4.4, which is the final essay. So for week three, you had to choose one of the two articles that you summarized in weeks one and two. And respond to one of those articles, right? So you would essentially be in conversation with one of the Harry Potter articles, one of the video game addiction articles. Week four, you're going to, in a sense, respond to both. I do have a suggested framework to follow, which I'll show in just a bit. But let's talk about this guy first, the one that's due Wednesday. As I said, by the way, in a kind of longish coronavirus-related announcement, I am being pretty flexible, okay, with people's due dates, people's stuff. Basically, if people get me assignments, I'll grade them no matter how late they are. If they're egregiously late, sure, I might take off some points for lateness, but I'm avoiding the serious penalties. The one that's supposed to be 5 points per day, up to 3 days, and after 3 days, it's a zero. I've been ignoring that for a couple reasons. One, because I usually ignore it. I'm trying to pass people, not fail them. Second, with the coronavirus, it's kind of, I think, time to be flexible. People's lives might be going crazy, or people might be trapped at home, which on one hand seems like it would be a great time to get the score done, but it can be difficult to concentrate. Right? So much news, so much worry, and so on. So yeah, for the foreseeable future, this might be months, I'll be flexible with students. So let's talk about the first time. Theoretically, do Wednesday called Gather the Right Pieces. One annoying thing about this new program is that, okay, I think I have the right thing. You should see 4.3, you have the right pieces. Okay, you can read through the instructions mostly on your own, but let me just repeat something I mentioned in the week three article, which is don't confuse those two paragraphs you wrote last week. Remember, there were three pairs of articles, one on walking your cat, one on emojis, and one on Facebook. Like, that was a one-time activity, okay? Sort of get you practiced at responding or thinking about an article critically, because that's what you had to do for Sunday's essay. But I think I show that every month I get a handful of students who get confused. And for the essay that was due Sunday, I get an essay on cat leashes or emojis. And no, that was a one-time assignment, okay? So we're dealing with those two articles you summarized back in weeks one and two. Okay? We're dealing with those all month. So for Sunday, you had to choose one article and respond to it. And for this week, you're going to respond to both articles. But to prepare you for this, you have this short activity, okay? Where you're essentially going to create three bullet lists, where you will identify 3 to 5 key ideas, the most important ideas, in your opinion, from one article, 3 to 5 key ideas from the second article, and then a kind of synthesis thing where you list 3 to 5 of your own ideas. Because ideally, it's going to be your ideas that you build the final essay around. Because at this point, in theory, you should be kind of like mini experts, because now you've read 2 articles on these topics, right? Streaming media, Harry Potter, video game addiction, etc. JC. And if you read both articles with care, and since you've now summarized both articles, and on Sunday you responded to one of the articles, now you should be in a position of confidence to be able to write and incorporate both articles. Okay, so to prepare you for this, we're just asking you to come up with a bullet list. Okay, so we're talking about a minimum of 9 sentences, a maximum of what, 15, right? 3 to 5 key ideas from one article, 3 to 5 key ideas from the second article, then 3 to 5 of your own ideas about the topic. As usual, every single activity in this class comes with examples. If you haven't looked at the examples in the past, I strongly recommend it, because what better way to learn, especially if lectures aren't the best way for you, than just to look at an example. There are students who sometimes the lecture doesn't work for them, the instructions doesn't work, it's not until they look at an actual student's sample assignment that things make sense. Okay. It does say it includes an EPA style reference for each article, which should be easy at this point. Okay, you had to create a reference for the week one summary, the week two summary, and for nearly all of you, I actually went into your papers and fixed the references for you. Don't say I'm not a handhold, because I do this a lot. Of course, a person needs to look at those in paper remarks. Okay, so usually I return people's papers, and there are some sentential accounts. And often I correct, if not one. Actually, to this point, it's always been just one reference. But yeah, if in weeks 1 and 2 I corrected them for you, just carry them over, okay, to this assignment. Or build them yourself by looking at either my corrections or the example. Okay, so yeah, you have an example. It's a PDF file. Open that up. So here you go. Okay, this person took 4 key ideas from this article. Okay. Found another 4 from this article. And then a kind of synthesis, he or she listed her own key ideas, 4 of them. Okay. And then the APA references. That's another thing too. You're still struggling with APA, even though in week 1 I showed in real time how to create references. If that's not the best way you learn, then just look at the example. Do the same thing. Author's last name, comma, first initial period, date in parentheses, full date, article title, name of the publication, italicized, and then the URL, the web address. Okay. So choose a method that you like, the lecture, the examples. But do get APA down, okay? So APA is a style system used in all wholesale classes. All of them. I think I've mentioned this before. And I think I've mentioned how some instructors are real sticklers. I mean, real sticklers. Like if they see that this month has been abbreviated instead of spelled out, or you get the name wrong or something, they might take off more points than you would imagine, more points than I do. Okay. But basically, you'll expect to have three major parts of APA now, which means paragraphing, so that, you know, double spacing an essay, indenting the first line of a new paragraph, using Times New Roman font, 12 points, so layout issues, in-text citations, so knowing how to quote something and put in a in-text citation. That was covered in week 3 lecture, by the way. So even though I didn't get to hold it live last week, I do recommend watching my lecture because I show real time. I just grab a sample line from an article and show how to incorporate it into a paragraph, complete with a in-text citation. And then the final part are these, the references, okay? So overall layout to in-text citations, quotations, and references. You'll be expected to have those three big picture areas of APA down path, okay? And if you can get those things down, you'll be fine. Because again, full sail, that's the style system used in all classes from here on out. Sometimes students might think, well, what's the big deal, APA? I mean, doesn't the quality of my writing matter most? Yes, but can I tell you from an instructor's viewpoint, it looks a little bit chaotic. If 20 students are handing in their paper 20 different ways, it's just a consistency, seeing 20 papers come in, all double spaced. All with first lines and paragraphs indented. It just looks nice. And it helps too, because it makes the writing look better. Kind of like making a first impression. It might not be fair that you can't show up to a job interview in sweats, but that's how things work. Okay, any questions about this assignment? Because I think this one is pretty straightforward. It's preparing you for the final essay by getting you to think about what the most important ideas are. From one article, from the second article, and then your own ideas. Again, you're going to use those two articles that you summarize in weeks 1 and 2. So I think we're all pretty cool there. So let's move on. Oh, we have someone else with us. Matthew's here. Welcome, Matthew. Okay. So let's go back to our list of activities. Week 4. Okay, so the other major activity, of course, is one due Sunday, the final essay. We've been working step by step. So weeks 1 and 2, you summarized 2 different articles. This past Sunday, you responded to 1 of the articles, and you were in conversation with 1 of the articles. Now you're gonna be in conversation with both. Let's take a look at this. There's one confusing part. Again, you can read the instructions mostly on your own. I need to point out to you 2 options, okay? I just went back in the chat. Okay, yeah, I'm in the right spot. So you can choose a blog post or a presentation. I don't like this language. Blog post just means essay. Okay, so don't get confused. Blog post just means an essay. So it still needs to be an APA format, still needs to have references. I think we're trying to suggest that, sure, if you had a blog, you could take this article and post it online. Ideally, it would be one of those kind of well-written, thoughtful pieces that I might come across online, much like the articles you summarized, right? So you're sort of aiming for that yourself. And just as articles you read online, you must make reference to other pieces and do so, they're highlighted links in the text, right? So they might literally be in conversation with other articles. You're doing the same thing. But don't be confused by the language. Blog post just means a traditional essay option or presentation. Just click here for requirements. Let's do that. It's just like a rubric. It should be showing a rubric. Okay, so you can see length. This essay should be 500 to 800 words. It's a little bit longer than the essay that was due on Sunday. You can see, still got to be an APA format. The presentation, let's talk about that, because the presentation, I teach creative presentation from time to time. I'm in the English department. Sometimes I help out, create presentation. So think of the presentation in those terms. remember in that class, we teach students to break bad habits. So it's not just about opening PowerPoint and flapping words on slides, because that's incredibly dull. Instead, we teach in that class how to use whatever tool, whether it's traditional presentation software like PowerPoint or something more sophisticated like iMovie or Adobe. Oh gosh, what is Adobe something? I'm blanking on the name. But anyway, you know these kinds of presentation tools, but use them dynamically. And so not to make just a static slide after slide where you take the contents of what you're saying, slap the words on the slides. No, creative presentation requires you to almost make like a mini movie. Write something that you could just sit back and watch the visuals slide by and hear the voiceover to match. And so I would always stress to students that there should be an image during the presentation with limited text, because the limited text and visuals are just acting as an anchor or a backdrop to what's really important, which is what you have to say. And so same thing here. So the presentation option does not mean I'm just going to slap words on the slides. You don't have to do the voiceover, but I should have a script that contains what you would say, right? Ideally, slide to slide. And you do have examples. So this is a little bit complicated as well, but your presentation example, blog post example. So let's take a look at the presentation example, because there's a link. Okay, so this is what you'd hand in. You can see there's, this is the voiceover, okay? This is what the person would say, slide, slide. You don't have to record voiceover like you did in creative presentation. If you want to, that's awesome, but you don't have to. And if you click here, you get an example. I believe this one has the voiceover. And yeah, just like creative presentation, you were looking for something that's like under 3 minutes. But you have this link here that you can click on to watch. But anyway, yeah, I mean, use the skills you learned in creative presentation here. I say this because most people just choose the essay option. The few people choose the presentation option, I've only seen like one or two that have been pretty good, because mostly people are choosing it because they think, oh, I can just throw words on the slides. Create a dozen slides with words slapped on them and maybe some visual elements. No, it's like creative presentation, okay? Remember that class? Remember how challenging it is? Because, yeah, it tries to break students of bad habits and teach them to make dynamic presentations. Presentations that are almost like mini movies, or the slides glide by effortlessly. They're primarily visual. So yeah, you sit back and you watch the images change to match the voiceover. Again, same thing here. It's just you don't have to record the voiceover. You don't want to. Okay, but because most people choose the essay option, let's take a look at that. Yeah, it's called blog post. Don't be fooled by that, okay? It's an essay. It just means your essay could appear online. As you can see here, still in APA format, still double spaced with first lines of paragraphs indented in Times New Roman 12 point font. There are references at the end. And same thing for you. And yeah, and blog post doesn't mean you have to begin by saying something like, hello, welcome to my blog. Because if you had a blog, you wouldn't do that. Maybe your very first post, you might. But if you regularly post like thoughtful, in-depth, almost like mini essays to your blog, yeah, it would take like this kind of form. So think of it more like an online article than a true blog post. Again, I'm not crazy about the language. I think it causes confusion. People see blog post, but it just means essay. Okay, but what do we have to do? I already said that in week 3, you wrote an essay where you responded to one article. Now you're in essence responding to both. So again, you can read through most of the instructions, but the important stuff is here. So you're going to write an essay that includes the following: a thesis or something that early on identifies their overall position on the issue. So what are your thoughts about Harry Potter? Should it be considered serious literature? Should it be considered literary or not? Video game addiction. real or overstated. Streaming media, same thing, okay? So your thesis, if that's too fancy a word, just kind of like what your main thrust is. Okay? The thing, the reason you're writing this paper, what's your overall takeaway? And that should be identified early on. At least two supporting points, okay? Ideas from both the articles and yourself, and at least one direct quote from each article, okay? With proper in-text citations. There are some tips here, but actually, here are the tips. Okay, so how do you structure this? Again, most people choose the essay option, so that's what I'm going to focus on. So here's a suggested framework. I think I have to switch the sharing mode. Okay, you should see my Microsoft Word document now. So you can either revisit the recording of this lecture to stop at this moment, or you can just take a screenshot now. Or you can jot things down if you need to. But here's like a general framework to follow. And notice how interesting, how similar this is, the week three structure. Again, we didn't have a live lecture week last week. Nobody showed up, but or one person did try to show up. But it's very, very similar in that we have, by the way, each Roman numeral represents a separate paragraph. Okay, so paragraph number one, an introduction. Okay. So we don't just dive into the middle of things. We set things up. Almost all writing has some sort of beginning. If introduction sounds too formal, think of it as a beginning. Okay, so find an interesting way to present your topic, introduce it, present it. Video game addiction, Harry Potter, streaming media, etc. And end the paragraph with your thesis, okay, your stance on the topic, which you will support one point at a time and three in the body paragraphs. Okay. So again, thesis, if that sounds too fancy, what is your overall takeaway? Should Harry Potter be considered literary? Is video game addiction real or overstated? And then we move to the middle paragraphs, okay? So one paragraph devoted to the first point you wish to make. And then you draw upon the article, if needed, for support. What is the second point you wish to make? Ditto, draw upon the article if needed. Third point you wish to make, okay? Then finally, a short conclusion paragraph where you bring things to a close. This basic structure, by the way, okay, having some sort of general beginning or introduction, having some sort of general conclusion or ending, and then separate paragraphs in between that focus on one topic at a time. If you can get those basics down, it will help you with any writing situation. Seriously, introduction, conclusion, separate paragraphs in between that focus on one point at a time. Now, in the real world, an introduction could be two paragraphs long, could be three paragraphs long. Conclusion could be more than one paragraph. You might spend several paragraphs on a single point. Maybe you have two things to say about this point. Okay? But for this short paper, probably you're going to have a single introduction paragraph, separate middle or body paragraphs for each point you wish to make, and a conclusion. Now, this structure, I think, is what the assignment is asking for. Sometimes I see students do a variation, which I'm also fine with. I think it leads to a more general paper, but because I do see it, I'm okay with it. And at a certain level, I just want to see your writing. So some students have, again, a general introduction that sets things up. Then they write a paragraph where they sort of summarize the first article, okay? More briefly than you did in weeks one or two. Just a short paragraph where you kind of get to the gist of one article and then respond to it in a separate paragraph. Summarize the other article, respond to it in another paragraph, and then a short conclusion. In other words, here you're building the essay around your points. Okay? So what is the first point you wish to make about the Harry Potter series? Maybe you have three ideas in mind for why the Harry Potter book should be considered serious literature. You're going to devote one paragraph each of those three points. Or you have three things to say about video game addiction, and why it's either real or overstated. Okay, you're going to devote separate paragraphs to each of the points you wish to make, folding in information from the article as needed. Okay, whereas here it's sort of reversed, or it's kind of similar to what I recommended for the three essay, which is you're not building things around your own points, but rather responding to the articles. Okay. And you can play with these structures. For example,
sure,
begin with a general introduction paragraph, take a brief moment to summarize the first article, and then maybe you have two paragraphs. But maybe there are two things you want to respond to in this article. Same thing here, briefly summarize the other article. And then maybe there are two paragraphs. You have two things you want to say about the second article. Okay? So don't look at these Roman numerals as so rigid that you must have exactly, in this case, six paragraphs. You can have 10 paragraphs. You can have five. You can have seven. Taisha says, when we submit our work, do you want both of these pages in our final draft? I'm not sure I understand what both those pages mean. I mean, I'm offering two different organization structures here. I mean, this is, I think, what the paper wants to be. The pages you are showing now. Right, I'm just showing two completely different ways to organize the essay. This is what I think the instructions are hoping for, that you're going to build an essay around three points you wish to make on the topic. Maybe I shouldn't have confused. Maybe I should have just stopped here to do this. But some students don't have their own ideas. Like, even though the assignment that's due Wednesday is designed to help them come up with their own thoughts on the topic, sometimes students aren't quite sure what to say about, for example, streaming media. And so, if they don't really have points that they wish to make, this is kind of a more simplified option, where you sort of are just briefly summarizing the article, responding. Summarizing the second article, responding to it. Okay. Taisha, you shouldn't be trying to like do both of these. Choose one that's more comfortable to you. And again, it's really a matter of just make sure you have some sort of introduction, some sort of conclusion, separate body paragraphs in between that focus on one point at a time. And really, the difference is whether you're building those paragraphs around your points and then using articles for support, or the opposite. You're building around the articles and you're responding to the ideas in those articles. And so one is kind of you based, the other one is more article based. And I think the second one, again, is for people who aren't super comfortable with forming their own thoughts on these topics, which I kind of get. Some people like the structures I offer in the lecture, but again, you have the basic instructions as well, where there are basic rules, things you should try to hit, plus tips, plus examples you can look at. Okay. So what's most important to me is that I see an organized essay. Okay. Some sort of organized piece that responds to both articles or includes information from both articles. By organized, I mean just what I talked about. Some sort of beginning, some sort of ending, and separate paragraphs in between that focus on one point at a time. If you can do that, I'm pretty open. Okay, I'm getting a caution saying I only have 8 minutes left. Unlike GoToTraining, Zoom has a limit on how long you can hold a meeting, which is good because anything over 40 minutes, I tend to lose people. Okay, so let's talk about. You also have an extra credit opportunity. It's only worth 5 points. 5 points added to a previous assignment, worth 10% of your grade. So my first piece of advice is, if you don't need those 5 points, don't do it. Unless you want to do it for fun. I'm not against people doing the extra credit opportunity. But so many students, their final grade is sort of determined. Like, there are people who are solidly in the A range or in the B range, the C range. And 5 points added is not going to change things that much. But if you think you might be on the borderline between one grade and another, you can, tackle this extra credit opportunity, which is to take this trollish review. Okay, so we all know trolling, right? So here's a person who clearly did not like Captain Marvel. I thought Captain Marvel was okay. I think it was great, but I thought it was good. But yeah, this person does not like it. Right, Captain Marvel's plot could not have been more idiotic. It was written in Cran. Nick Fury was cinematically emasculated.
apparently Brie Larson couldn't tolerate sharing the spotlight. Yeah, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say this is written by a dude. This is written by a guy. Like, whether you like Captain Marvel or not, I thought it was good. Not great, but good. But yeah, lots of people got really angry. You know, it's almost entirely men. Like, if you don't like the movie, you don't like the movie. But I don't, it doesn't anger me that it was a female superhero. Get ready, there are going to be more. Actually, I can't wait for that Black Widow movie with Scarlett Johansson. Anyway, but yeah, this is a trolling review, okay? So broad swipes, like, the movie's idiotic, like it was written in crayon. I highly doubt that it was written that badly. But your task is to take this and rewrite it, okay? Rewrite it in a way that is more grounded, less angry. Remember in week one, I said that one of the goals in this class is to get people to think more, okay? So read things. Prove that you understand what's been written before you respond to it. I think I also said that people are awesome at giving opinions. They're almost too awesome at giving opinions, especially knee-jerk opinions like this one is. Okay, yeah, the guy's permitted not to like the movie. But yeah, I don't know. Isn't there, like professional reviewers who maybe didn't like Captain Marvel, would not write something like this, okay? So your task is to de-troll or untroll this piece. Rewrite it so that it sounds more, yeah, grounded. Like, clearly you don't like the movie, but you don't sound like you were writing all caps, right? Which is shouting. But again, it's worth only 5 points. I think it should be worth more, but okay, it's worth 5 points. That's not a lot. For most people, it's not going to be a difference maker. So guesstimate your grade. Okay, guesstimate them based on what still needs to be handed in, where you think you might be. And if you fear that you're on the edge between one grade and another, and keep in mind, things round up. So an 89.5 rounds up to a 90, an A. 84.5, right, rounds up to an 85, B plus instead of just a B. Okay, so if you really feel like you're at that edge, then sure, take a stab at this. But if not, yeah, give yourself a break. Again, unless you really want to do it for fun, that's fine. But most people are busy, so if you can leave things off your plate, you can do so. Finally, there's a short reflection essay. It's a word to present your grade, but there's a professionalism deduction for not doing it. Don't worry, though. It's a simple task. It says essay, and yes, it is an essay, but it's not being graded in the way we typically grade essays. Okay? Essentially, you're going to write in essay form an answer to these questions. You're not just going to copy one question, answer, copy another question, answer. No, you're going to take these questions and turn them into, you know, something that's a page long. It should be an APA format, but that just means, you know, you don't have to worry about citations or references. Just make sure that it's double-spaced in the proper font. Okay? It's not an essay in the traditional sense. You're not going to receive a grade for it. You just have to answer these things. Okay? Because we only have 3 minutes left, questions, comments, anything that people want to discuss? Am I still sharing the wrong screen? Oh, I did it again. I'm so sorry. So I showed, I mean, I'll take the blame, of course, but oh, I wish someone had told me. Unlike GoTo, it doesn't just automatically share whatever screen. So here's the trolling thing. I'm sorry. I was talking about it, but you couldn't see it. So here we go. I haven't told you. Okay. And here's the Captain Marvel review. This is what you have to rewrite. Go over the reflection. Yes, yes, yes. Get out of here. Clock is ticking. 2.5 minutes. I still get used to Zoom's sharing. Okay, so you should see the portfolio now. Okay. You just have to answer these questions and turn them into an essay. Oddly, we don't have a sample for this one. But yeah, you're just answering these bulleted questions, but in essay format. And now I'm being kicked out. less than 1 minute. Okay, so if you have questions or comments, I'm afraid you're gonna have to send them to me online. I apologize. I have no idea why Zoom limits these to 40 minutes. I don't have a problem with the 40 minute time limit, but it would be nice if, tell me, yeah, I can upgrade for more money for a longer session. Okay, since we're gonna be cut off any second, I'm going to say goodbye. If you have questions, please let me know via FSL. Okay, but you should be seeing the reflection thing to answer. It's just these bullet points, okay? You're gonna answer an essay.